Dear students, today I will explain the chapter The 100 Races second part, which is written by Eleanor Esters. So this is the second part of The 100 Races. So now see here. While the class was circling the room, the monitor from the principal office brought Miss Mason a note. So now all the students moving in the class and saw the drawings of wonders, and at the same time monitor brought a letter from the principal office for Miss Mason. Here Miss Mason was the class teacher of room number 13. Now circling means taking a round. Miss Mason read it several times and studied it thoughtfully for a while. So when Miss Mason received the letter, she read letter many times and studied thoughtful. Here thoughtfully means seriously for a while. So she read the letter many times and also she became serious after reading the letter. Then she clapped her hands, but she did not show that there is something very very serious. Attention class, everyone back to their seat. So after that she said that please attention and come back to your seat. While the shuffling of feet had stopped and the room was still and quiet, Miss Mason said, I have a letter from Wanda's father that I want to read to you. So when everyone stopped moving in the class and sit at their proper place, and all the class become quiet, at that time Miss Mason said that I have received a letter from Wanda's father and now I want to read it. And she said that now I am going to read it for you. So everyone be quiet and listen it very carefully. Miss Mason stood there a moment and the silence in the room grew tense and expectant. Here tense and expectant means serious and hopeful, and here shuffling means beating the floor by feet. So when Miss Mason stood there a moment and the silence in the room grew tense and expectant. So when Miss Mason ready to read the letter, at that time everyone thought that this is a serious matter, important matter for a moment, because for Miss Mason also was quiet for a moment. The teacher adjusted her glasses slowly and deliberately. Her manner indicated that what was coming, this letter from Wanda's father, was a matter of great importance. So Miss Mason stood and also set their glasses, and everyone thought that maybe the letter of Wanda's father has a serious matter. That's why Miss Mason set the glasses and also she was showing that this is the important matter. Everybody listened closely as Miss Mason read the brief note. And now everyone ready to listen the letter and also listened it very closely. Here listen closely means listened with attention without any making noise. And now Miss Mason was going to read a brief note. Now what is in the letter? See here. Dear teacher, my Wanda will not come to your school anymore. Jack also. Now we move away to big city. No more holler pack. Here holler pack means making fun and teasing. No more ask why funny name. Plenty of funny names in the big city. Yours truly, Jan Petronsky. So now, what is in the letter of Wanda's father? Wanda's father said that now we will go to a big city, and from the next time my children will not study in your school. Here Wanda's and Jack was also the child of Jan Petronsky. Here Jan Petronsky was the father of Wanda's. And also Wanda's father described in the letter that he will go to big city, and also in that big city no more holler pack. It means no anyone make fun of for the long names, and no more ask why funny names, and also no anyone ask about the name if the name is longer or funny. Plenty of funny names in the big city. And also he said that there are so many names in the big city, and also the name is funny and big, but no anyone make tease or make fun of anyone. So now we will go to big city, and my children will not go to your school again. Yours truly, Jan Petronsky. So in this way Wanda and Jack left their school and moved to big city.